you doing? Welcome back to my channel. So guys, I understand that the economy is not doing us very well, and in a bit to try and survive, I am bringing you ways, different ways in which you can save a coin. Today we do a video on how to make charcoal briquettes so that you can reduce those electricity and charcoal costs. Let's introduce our ingredients, guys. Of course, it is charcoal briquette, so you'll expect charcoal dust. It is here. Now this charcoal dust, it's supposed to be very fine, and you can see it has some dirt that is supposed to be out of it. So we are going to sieve it. And is this flour? This is cassava flour. This is what we are going to use as our binding agent. Water. We have our water here. So those are the three things that we are going to focus on today, and as our ingredients for this video. To tackle this procedure, make sure you have something like a mask. I don't have a mask, but I have some cloth, a piece of cloth that I have tied around my neck. This is what I'm going to use to cover my nose, because it is very dusty. And you So guys, you can see my sifted charcoal dust. It is now clean and ready to be used. Now I'm going to measure it with this so that I can know the quantity that I am dealing with. Of course, because of the measurements of other ingredients, I need to know the quantity. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to measure the dust. So this is one. Two. The remaining one is not much, so I can simply conclude that I have two of these. So let me just take it back. So guys, that is step number one. So step number two, I want to add in some water into the charcoal dust so that it can be easier to work with, you know. It is too dusty. And also, before I add the flour, I need to make it I don't know, I need to mix it up first before I add the flour. So that is exactly what I'm going to do right now. Now, I'm not going to tell you exactly how much water you should add. Just add as long as you are able to, not too much and not too little, as long as you are able to mold it with your hand, then you are good to go. So I simply add little by little as I need. So the water is enough. At least now I can do without this. Now I don't need this. And now the next step will be now to add the flour. But now you're not going to add the flour as it is, guys. You're going to make a paste, and that paste you are going to cook it. You know, the same way you make uji is the same way you're going to make this. So now let us go and make our uji. And measured one flour of that tin. I'm going to add some water and then as I stir, guys. Just the way you make uji, by the way, so that it doesn't have those balls. So I'll add water as I stir first. Again, now I can't tell you the specific amount of water to add. Just add. Basically, just cook it as the way you cook porridge. Just cook it the way you cook porridge. So I'll mix it a bit with cold water before I can turn on the heat. So this is our porridge, guys. It should be thicker than the normal porridge. So this is it. We're going to give it time so that it can cook a bit before we can take it off. Guys, our heated flour is ready. You're supposed to give it some time so that it can cool, because it comes out very hot and it can burn you. So now, guys, I made an error. You don't need too much of that flour. Actually, we only need this tin, so that we can mix it in the two parts of this. So now just take like three spoons of flour. Is enough of cassava flour is enough. So now I'm just going to take one of these and then I'll pour it in the charcoal dust so that we can start our molding process. It has cooled. Now you have poured it in the charcoal dust. You can now start mixing with your hand. as you mix, you can even feel it. You can even feel that it is becoming sticky because of the cassava flour that we have used to bind it together. Guys, our mixture is ready for molding. Make sure it is not too watery, because now it will be difficult to mold. So now this is it. If you find that yours is too watery, you can always add more charcoal dust just to make it the right consistency. Now when it comes to molding, you can mold with your hands. Yeah, you just do this until you get your desired size. You know, then you put it there. Or you can also use something to mold, like this one, just a plastic thing that I picked in my compound. You can use it for easier work. You can just put it, and then for also so that it can give you the consistent size or shape. So you simply put it like this, and then you release it. You put it again, you release it. And the best thing with this one, you can also recruit your family members so that they can help you make them. So this one will help you get a consistent shape. And it is also faster, by the way. I find it to be faster than using your own hands. I told you it's a dirty process, so you have to be prepared. Make sure that you're not making your balls too big for drying purposes, so that they can dry from outside to inside, because they can only burn well if they are well dried. So make sure the balls are of the right sizes, not too small and not too big. We are done with our molding. You can see our briquettes are now all molded and ready for drying. But now it is late in the evening, so there is no sun right now. So this is what we will do tomorrow in the morning. We will put it out there so that it can dry. It takes about 3 to 4 days for it to fully dry up. So give it time so that it can also light well. I hope you have learned something, guys. I hope you can try this at home. It is another way of getting clean energy and also just saving on your charcoal, because now charcoal dust is cheaper. I actually bought mine 2 kg for 50 Kenya shillings. Also, you can also just buy the flour, just you need a little bit of it. So this is actually a cheaper way of actually lighting or heating your home. So thank you so much for watching. I hope to meet you in the next video. See you. Don't forget to subscribe, okay?